हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम यू ऑल टू द इंग्लिश क्लास। टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग चैप्टर नंबर 5, मदर्स डे, रिटन बाय जेबी प्रीस्टले। स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस चैप्टर द ऑथर हैज़ ट्राइड टू प्रेजेंट द पोजिशन ऑफ द वीमेन इन द वर्ल्ड एंड ऑल्सो ही हैज़ प्रेजेंटेड द पोजिशन ऑफ द वीमेन इन अ ह्यूमरस एंड सेट्रिकल वे। सो नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट। द फॉलोइंग प्ले इज अ ह्यूमरस पोर्ट्रेयल ऑफ द स्टेटस ऑफ द मदर इन अ फैमिली। स्टूडेंट्स, एज इट इज़ अ प्ले, मदर्स डे इज अ प्ले, प्ले दैट इज प्रेजेंटेड ऑन द स्टेज एंड इट इज़ अ ह्यूमरस पोर्ट्रेयल ऑफ द स्टेटस ऑफ द मदर इन द फैमिली। इन दिस प्ले द ऑथर हैज डिस्क्राइब द पोजिशन ऑफ द वीमेन स्टेटस ऑफ द मदर इन द फैमिली। लेट्स रीड ऑन टू सी हाउ Mrs. Pearson's family reacts when she tries to stand up for her own rights. So here the main character of the play is Mrs. Pearson, and we will read here how her family reacts when she tries to stand up for her own rights, when she demands her own rights. Characters: the main characters of the play are Pearson, Mrs. Annie Pearson. She is a very weak lady. She is gentle, she is simple, she is very much innocent. George Pearson, husband of Mrs. Annie Pearson, who is dominating, and he doesn't care of Annie Pearson. He is not considerate towards Annie Pearson. Doris Pearson, she is daughter of Annie Pearson. Cyril Pearson, son of Annie Pearson. Mrs. Fitzgerald is her neighbor. She is her friend, and she is also a fortune teller. As she has learned this art, she is a fortune teller, and she is a very dominating bold lady. The action takes place in the living room of the Pearson's house in a London suburb. Now, the action means the play starts. As it starts on the stage, it is performed on the stage. And it is the living room of the Pearson's house in a London suburb, means they are living in London. Time, the present. Scene. The living room of the Pearson family. Afternoon, it is afternoon time, and it is the living room of the Pearson family. It is a comfortably furnished, much lived in room in a small suburban semi-detached villa. If necessary, only one door need be used, but it is better with two, one up left leading to the front door and the stairs, and the other in the right wall leading to the kitchen and the back door. There can be a muslin covered window in the left wall and possibly one in the right wall. 2. The fireplace is assumed to be in the fourth wall. There is a settee upright, an armchair down left and one down right, a small table with two chairs on either side of it stands at the center. When the play is performed on the stage, when the scene starts, this is the condition of the room where the play is performed. And here in this para it is said that where all the things are kept on the stage. When the curtain rises, it is an afternoon in early autumn and the stage can be well lit. Mrs. Pearson at right and Mrs. Fitzgerald at left are sitting opposite each other at the small table on which are two teacups and saucers and the cards with which Mrs. Fitzgerald has been telling Mrs. Pearson's fortune. Now, when the play starts, we see that when the curtain rises, the two ladies, Mrs. Pearson and Mrs. Fitzgerald, are sitting opposite to each other and there are cards also on the table and Mrs. Fitzgerald has been telling Mrs. Pearson's future. She is telling about her fortune. Mrs. Pearson is a pleasant but worried looking woman in her 40s. Mrs. Pearson is a pleasant but she looks very much worried woman and she is going through 40s. Mrs. Fitzgerald is older, heavier, and a strong and sinister personality. शी इज स्मोकिंग. इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट दीज टू शुड हैव शार्पली कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग वॉइसिस. मिसिज पियर्सन स्पीकिंग इन अ लाइट फ्लरिड सॉर्ट ऑफ टोन. फ्लरिड मीन्स वेरी शी इज़ वेरी मच नर्वस. हर वॉइस शोज दैट शी इज़ नर्वस. शी स्पीक्स इन सच अ टोन विद अ टच ऑफ सब अर्बन कॉकनी परहैप्स. कॉकनी मीन्स ईस्ट एंड ऑफ लंडन. एंड मिसिज फिट्ज़ेरल्ड विद अ डीप वॉइस रादर आयरिश परहैप्स. And perhaps it looks that she belongs to, she is a native of Irish land. Now both the ladies are talking to each other. Here it is described, the description of Mrs. Pearson and Mrs. Fitzgerald. And they both are opposite to each other. Now the conversation between Mrs. Fitzgerald and Mrs. Pearson starts. Collecting up the cards. And that's all I can tell you, Mrs. Pearson. Could be a good fortune, could be a bad one. All depends on yourself now. Make up your mind and there it is. Now, Mrs. Fitzgerald tells her she collects the cards and tells her that this is all that I have told you, that I can tell you. Now, you could have a good fortune and also you could have a bad fortune. It all depends only upon you. You have to make up your mind and then it is up to you. How you make up your mind and how your fortune seems to be, whether it is bad or good. Mrs. Pearson. Yes, thank you. Mrs. Fitzgerald. I am much obliged, I am sure. It's wonderful having a real fortune teller living next door. Did you learn that out east too? Now Mrs. Pearson is very much thankful to her. And also she feels very happy that she is a real fortune teller and living in the next door. She is a neighborhood. She is her neighbor. And then also she puts her question if she had learned this art in East. Mrs. Fitzgerald. I did. 12 years I had of it with my old man. Rising to be lieutenant quartermaster. He learned a lot and I learned a lot more. Now, she says that she had learned this art in East, in the Asian countries. And also she says that here that she spent there 12 years. And she lived there with her father when he was getting training of lieutenant quartermaster. And he learned a lot and she also learned a lot. She learned the art of fortune telling. But will you make up your mind now, Mrs. Pearson dear? Put your foot down. Once and for all and be the mistress of your own house and the boss of your own family. And then she says her that you should use your own authority. You have to stop all this what is happening with you. You have to make up your mind. You have to be mistress of your family and you have to be boss of, you have to become the boss of your family. Mrs. Pearson, smiling apologetically. That's easier said than done. Besides, I'm so fond of them even if they are so thoughtless and selfish, they don't mean to be. Now, she tells her about her family members, about her husband, about her children. She says that it's very easy to say, but it will not be done by her. And also, she is very much fond of her family. Although her family members all are thoughtless and they all are selfish. Mrs. Fitzgerald, cutting in. Maybe not, but it would be better for them if they learned to treat you properly. But Mrs. Fitzgerald says that it would be better for them if they treat you properly. They have to behave properly with you. Mrs. Pearson, yes, I suppose it would in a way. Mrs. Fitzgerald, no doubt about it at all. Who's a better for being spoiled grown man? Lad or girl? Nobody. You think it does them good when you run after them all the time? Take their orders as if you were the servant in the house? Stay at home every night while they go out and enjoy themselves? Now, she says that. She asks him who is the better one for being who is being spoiled. Who is the better who is being spoiled? That is, a grown man. She is asking about her husband, about her son and about her daughter. And then also she says that every time you are following them, you are doing good for them, you are running after them, you are fulfilling their needs, and they are giving you orders just like the servants. And every day you stay home at night, but they are enjoying themselves when they go outside of their house. Never in all your life. It's a ruin of them as well as you. Now she says that it will only not ruin you, it will ruin to them also. Husbands, sons, daughters should be taking notice of wives and mothers, not giving them orders and treating them like dirt. Also, she is of the views, Mrs. Fitzgerald has the views, that the husband, son and daughters, they should take notice of the wives and the mothers, and they should not give them orders, and also should not treat them like the dirt. And don't tell me you don't know what I mean, for I know more than you have told me. Also, she says that she knows more whatever she had told her, as Mrs. Pearson had told her about the family. But after knowing about her fortune, as she is a fortune teller, after knowing about her fortune, when she had seen her hand, she had come to know about her family members. Now she says that she knows everything more than that she had told her. Mrs. Pearson, dubiously, I keep dropping a hint. Mrs. Fitzgerald, hint? It's more than hints your family needs, Mrs. Pearson. But Mrs. Pearson says that most of the times when she converses with them, she gives the hints in between the sentence. But Mrs. Fitzgerald says that the hints will not work. Your family needs more than the hints. Mrs. Pearson, dubiously, I suppose it is, but I do hate any unpleasantness. And it's so hard to know where to start. I keep making up my mind to have it out with them, but somehow I don't know how to begin. She glances at her watch or at a clock. Oh, good gracious, look at the time. Nothing ready and they'll be home any minute and probably all in a hurry to go out again. Now, Mrs. Pearson says here that she would never be unpleasant with them. She hates to be unpleasantness. And also she says that it's very hard for me to start with them, to tell them that, to tell them not to behave like that. And then she suddenly looks at the watch and she says that nothing is ready in the house and every member of the family is coming to the house. And when and after coming to the house, they would be in a hurry as they have to go out. As she is about to rise, Mrs. Fitzgerald reaches out across the table and pulls her down. Mrs. Fitzgerald doesn't let her go. She pulls her down and she sits. Mrs. Fitzgerald, let them wait or look after themselves for once. This is where your foot goes down. Start now. She lights a cigarette from the one she has just finished. Then she says, Mrs. Fitzgerald advises her not to do work for them. She says that let them do the work themselves and look after themselves. And also then she starts smoking the cigarette. Mrs. Pearson, embarrassed. Mrs. Fitzgerald, I know you mean well. In fact, I agree with you. But I just can't. And it's no use you trying to make me. If I promise you I would really have it out with them, I know I wouldn't be able to keep my promise. Now Mrs. Pearson, she is embarrassed, she is shameful, and she says that, I know that she says her that she is right, she also agrees with her, but also she says that she cannot follow her, she will not act as she says, and also she would not promise for that, even she would not be able to keep her promise. Mrs. Fitzgerald, then let me do it. Mrs. Pearson, flustered. Oh no, thank you very much, Mrs. Fitzgerald, but that wouldn't do at all. It couldn't possibly be somebody else. They would resent it at once. Resent means hateful and opposed. And wouldn't listen, and really I couldn't blame them. I know I ought to do it, but you see how it is. She looks apologetically across the table, smiling rather miserably. Then she says that she thanks her as she had said that then she would do something for her, but Mrs. Pearson says that it would not be possible. It would not be possible for anyone to do something for her, as if anybody would do something for her, then the family member would start opposing her. They would hate her. And also she says that she would not blame the persons who are helping. Mrs. Fitzgerald, coolly, you haven't got the idea. Mrs. Pearson, bewildered. Bewildered means puzzled. Oh, I'm sorry, I thought you asked me to let you do it. Mrs. Fitzgerald, I did, but not as me, as you. Mrs. Pearson, but I don't understand, you couldn't be me. Mrs. Fitzgerald, coolly, we change places or really bodies, you look like me, I look like you. Now, she tells her about the plan that she was doing something for her when she would change the places and Mrs. Pearson would look like Fitzgerald and Fitzgerald would look like Mrs. Pearson. Mrs. Pearson, but that's impossible. Mrs. Fitzgerald, how do you know? Ever tried it? Mrs. Pearson, no, of course not. But Mrs. Pearson feels that it's impossible, it would never be possible to change the places. Then Mrs. Fitzgerald says that, have you ever tried it? Mrs. Fitzgerald, coolly, I have. Not for some time, but it still ought to work. Won't last long, but long enough for what we want to do. Learn it. Learn it out. East, of course, where they are up to. All these tricks. She holds her hand out across the table, keeping the cigarette in her mouth. Give me your hands, dear. Give means give me your hands. Mrs. Pearson, dubiously, well, I don't know. Is it right? Now Mrs. Fitzgerald again says that she has learned this art. Learned this art in the East, in the Asian countries, and it is the place where all these tricks are done. And she is also very much hopeful that this idea would surely work. Mrs. Pearson, well, I don't know, is it right? Mrs. Fitzgerald, it is your only chance. Give me your hands and keep quiet a minute. Just don't think about anything. Taking her hands, now look at me. They stare at each other, muttering, Ashtama dum, Ashtama lam, Ashtata lam dum bona. Now, she mutters something in the mouth, she spells, and she tells Mrs. Pearson to keep quiet for the minute. This little scene should be acted very carefully. We are to assume that the personalities change bodies. After the spell has been spoken, both women, still grasping hands, go lax as if the life were out of them. Now, after muttering this spell, their bodies, their personalities change, and they both start, both women grasp the hands of each other, they go lax and as if their lives are out of them. And then both come to life, but with the personality of the other. Each must try to adopt the voice and mannerism of the other. So now Mrs. Pearson is bold and dominating and Mrs. Fitzgerald is nervous and fluttering. Now their bodies are changed, personalities are changed, and Mrs. Pearson looks now bold and dominating and Mrs. Fitzgerald is looking nervous and fluttering. Now both the personalities are changed, and what happens after that, we will read in the next class. Till then, goodbye and have a nice day.